Project Bounty is very important. You're going to need to be on your best behavior. We don't need an episode like last time. Understand? Heated scotch in a nosing glass.
No, we don't have those here.
Very well.
You bring your own glass to the bar?
This is the way. And one for the kid.
I don't think so, little guy.
Trust me, he's older than the both of us combined.
Got any ID? I don't need to see your ID.
Thank you.
Are you gonna take your helmet off?
A Mandalorian never removes his helmet.
How are you gonna drink?
This is the way.
Hey doll, if you want a tip, you'll bring me some ice, okay? Thanks.
We're looking for a couple fugitives. Have you seen them?
Are they your brothers or something?
They're wanted for impersonating the Mandalorian and for making terrible music.
Never seen them.
What about him?
Hey, don't forget my ice! And maybe just bring the whole bottle over. I'm gonna be here all night, right? If you were a laser, you'd be set to stunning. I must be from Eldoran because you just blew up my world. I can make you breathe harder than Vader with his mask on. Thanks, hon.
Hey!
Is that man disturbing you?
Yes.
Oh, you like that? Woo! Get another bottle over here.
I think you've had enough.
I said I wanted ice.
Leave the lady alone.
Aren't you that electric dance DJ guy?
Hey, welcome to Sipper Social Club. I'm Mando. Thank you so much for watching the Halloween video. Hope you liked it. If you did, throw a comment down below. Give me a like. If you're new to this channel, you haven't subscribed before, hit that subscribe button, bell notification. If you really like this stuff, you can check us out on Patreon. Link down below.
I want to discuss real quick kind of the theme of the video, and that is how to enjoy whiskey. There's a lot of stigma about snobbiness in whiskey and how you should enjoy it. In my opinion, you should enjoy whiskey however you want, whether you drink it neat, with water, on the rocks, mix it. It doesn't really matter. The enjoyment factor is completely up to you. Once you purchase that bottle, you can do whatever you want with it. You could take it 10 feet in the air, pour it all over the place. It doesn't really matter. But enjoyment versus appreciation are kind of two different things. And I want to kind of talk about enjoyment factor versus appreciation of whiskey and methods to appreciate whiskey the way it was meant to be. Most of the stuff I'm going to mention will be completely obvious to most of my subscribers, but if you're brand new to whiskey, I'll go over what I think is the best way to appreciate whiskey and what to do and what not to do. The very first thing is the type of glass you're drinking out of. So, two typical whiskey glasses, the tumbler, big opening, the Glencairn tulip-shaped glass, smaller opening, very obvious. The intensity of what you're getting on your nose, very much more concentrated with this glass versus this one. It's not rocket science, you can do it very easily. I'm gonna be drinking this Old Granddad, and this is one of my favorite budget bourbons. I think it's absolutely great for the price. You can find this bottle for about $25 US. It's bottled at 100 proof, 50 ABV. It's made by Jim Beam. It's one of their high rye bourbons. Very, very delicious stuff. Really quick on the nose. Lots of typical bourbon flavors coming out of this. You get the brown sugars, caramels, a little bit of cherry, nice rye spice, a little bit of oak. When you nose it with the rocks glass, substantially less impact, less intensity. Picking up those subtle notes may be a little bit more difficult. Very easy to go back and forth, and you definitely get more out of this glass than you do this glass. All right, what happens when you add ice? Well, it's the complete obvious things. One is cooling the liquid, and two is diluting it a little bit. I'm adding water into the whiskey. The complexity has been diminished, without a doubt. Instead of getting those nice rounded spice notes with the peanut note in this, kind of very faded, and I'd say the delicate spicy notes still there, just less intense. So what happens when you add ice to whiskey is those delicate flavor molecules in the alcohol tighten up, they close up, they are less intense. That's why adding ice to a younger whiskey that has more sharp alcohol notes kind of brings that down. It's a lot more palatable, a lot easier to drink. And there's science to back this up. According to a publication titled Chemosensory Perception, the Influence of Stimulus Temperature, participants were given various flavor solutions and reported them tasting weaker or less intense when they were chilled. Pretty straightforward, not really a shocker at all. All right, so what happens when you move up in class? Let's say you wanted to go to something like this, 12-year-old Scotch whiskey, the Glenfiddich, one of the most popular selling single malt Scotch whiskeys in the world. Out of this, I get really nice pear, apple, nice oak note, maybe just a little bit of like dark chocolate in there, maybe a little bit of sweetness, a little bit of honey on that palate. Now, going to the one with ice. So that pear note, gone, completely gone. Don't really get much pear. A little bit of apple, the sweetness a little bit there, and that bitter dark chocolate, very diminished for sure. So you can 100% tell that the subtle complexities of a Scotch whiskey are very much diminished with ice. Of course, that youthful alcohol note that you might get at neat is definitely reduced with the ice. Enjoyment factor, you can definitely enjoy both of these, but to appreciate the 12 years in the cask that this Scotch has sat there for, all the subtle nuances that make whiskey really, really good, and why a lot of people like it, it's why it's the most flavorful spirit in the world. It's not like a vodka where they distill it, you know, multiple times to strip out all the flavor. They want to keep the flavor in this. So to truly appreciate what the whiskey maker is doing in this bottle, putting ice in it is definitely diminishing that. All right, let's take it to the extreme. I kind of hate doing this with Highland Park 18, but for science purposes, I'll pour a little bit over ice. You guys know what I'm going to say. It's going to be the same thing as before. The reason why Highland Park 18 is such a great whiskey is because it has all these very subtle nuances in it. You can pick out a lot of different flavors in this. For me, Highland Park has this amazing sweet honey note, just a little bit of subtle peat. It's got great fruit. The oak notes are very well balanced in it. It spent 18 long years in a barrel. And to put ice in this whiskey, in my opinion, you completely ruin the appreciation of it. Because these molecules are getting tightened up, the flavor is reduced, you're not getting what makes this whiskey good when you add ice to it. So just real quick, let's have a sip. So yeah, you might still enjoy this, but I'm not getting what I would get out of this glass. In my opinion, it's kind of like owning a Ferrari. Sure, you can have a Ferrari and you can have the status of having a really nice car in the driveway, but if you're only driving it under the speed limit, you're not appreciating the full potential of that car when you're only driving it super slow. Sure, you can enjoy it on valet mode all you want, and you can have the status of owning it, but you're never gonna appreciate it when you drive it like that. Just the same with this Scotch whiskey. You're never gonna appreciate it when you throw ice on it. Sure, you might enjoy it, but you're not letting the whiskey maker show his true talent and blending capabilities when you dilute it with ice and close up those flavor molecules and reduce the flavor. So, my opinion, of course, appreciation different than enjoyment. Enjoy whiskey however you want. Don't let anyone tell you different. If you want to appreciate it, you want to have whiskey for what it's truly meant to be. Nose in glass, no ice, a little bit of water sometimes opens up the flavor, but never, ever, ever chill it down if you want to get the full potential out of what you're drinking.
This is the way.
That's my opinion. If you have a different opinion, let me know in the comments down below. I love to hear it. And when is a good time to add ice to whiskey? There's definitely some great times to enjoy whiskey on the rocks. Let me know your favorite whiskey to put ice cubes in, and maybe a climate or a time where you prefer it with a little bit of ice. Thank you so much for watching. Really hope you enjoy the Halloween videos. If you do, of course, again, comment down below, give me a like. If you want to support this channel a bit more, you love the Halloween stuff, check out Patreon. You can win some amazing whiskey, some merch, and some behind the scene videos of this Halloween episode. There were some hilarious outtakes. Those will be up really, really soon. So if you want to subscribe, check out Patreon. You can get access to that video. It was some hilarious stuff. I want to thank Ryan, Camila, and Lynn for helping me out on that video. It was really a great time, and you'll see it in behind the scenes stuff as well. Thanks so much, guys. Really much appreciated. Have a good one. Cheers.
That's good.
Oh, okay.
Because we need the sounds of like the.
Okay. Next time, if he starts to tip, just grab him and hold him up. Okay. Just grab
him and hold him. That's so good.
You want a car seat?
Okay, come on. We can do this.